costly made for sinners. Every curse his blood has torn. Final breath and it is finished. But not the end we could have known. For the earth began to shake and the veil. As the heavens grow, all hail King Jesus, all hail the Lord of heaven and earth, all hail King Jesus. There was a moment when the sky lit up, flash of light breaking through. When all was lost, he crossed eternity. King of life was on the move, for in a dark, cold tomb, our Lord was laid, one miraculous bread, and we're forever changed. All hail King Jesus. Let us join with all of heaven. Thank you.
Deserve it. God, you went to the cross for our sins and you died a death you didn't deserve and you rose again for us. God, we remember that tonight. I pray that it would just encourage us, that the things that we're walking through that feel so big, that feel impossible to even conquer, God, would you remind us that you are a big God. God, you're so much bigger than the fight we're going on with, that you're having with a friend. Small things like fighting with your parents. But even the big things, God. You deserve all of our praise. A reminder of that tonight. We love you, Father. Amen.
You faithful, and I just wanna thank you. So Lord, we thank you that you've been so good to us. Even at times we have been unfaithful to you, you've always been faithful to us. Even at times when we haven't always followed the ways that you've wanted us to go, you've still poured out your goodness on our lives. I thank you what the scriptures say, Lord, is that your goodness and your mercy, they follow us all the days of our lives. That we can't shake your goodness. Lord, I pray every student within this circle would understand tonight that your goodness is chasing after them. Lord, we can't shake all the good things that you want to do in and through us. And the beautiful thing is, it's in spite of us. It's in spite of our brokenness. It's in spite of our sin. It's in spite of the things that we struggle with. Your goodness just keeps on coming through us. We're thankful for that tonight. We're thankful for Jesus that we're here for. We're here to exalt Jesus. We're here to know who Jesus is. We're here to lean into him more. Everything revolves around Jesus. Lord, Jesus, when you came to this earth, it changed all of human history. Even the very time, it changed time. Changed how we see the world and world history. Jesus, when you came here, it changed everything. And so now we just worship you. We thank you, Lord, that we get to come in this place and to give you glory. And so as we move on from this space and to other things we're going to do tonight, Lord, I pray, God, that you would solidify this moment. I pray, God, this would be a worshiping community. This would be a place that not just on a Sunday night, but we're worshiping you all throughout the week, different times, different places, different songs, whatever it looks like, but we're worshiping a group of students. So thank you for these amazing students that have come. In Jesus' name we pray. Everyone say amen. 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 Come on, give Jesus some praise tonight. It's why we're here. And hey, it's also super challenging for our worship team to lead you in worship in a setting this way different. So give it up for our worship team. We did a great job. Awesome time. And hey, what's next week? Hey, what are you gonna do? Bring a what? Bring a friend. Come on, it's gonna be a great week. Everyone put your threes up. Everyone put your threes up. 3 minute break. You guys have 3 minutes to go to the bathroom, to get some water, take a break, say hi to a friend. At the end of those 3 minutes, middle school's in that room, high school's back in here. 3 minute break starts right now.
walking around like I was missing. Are we on? I think we're on. Perfect. Hey, everybody, we are going to play a game. But here's what I need. Here's what I need you to guys do, okay? I need you to get into your connect groups with ladies on this side and guys on this side. Get in your connect groups. Make sure you have space in between the other groups. And you'll find out why here in a second. If you need extra room, you can come in the middle right over here. Make sure you have plenty of room. Where's all the senior guys at? Senior guys right over there. All right, give me a thumbs up when you guys have your group. Give me a thumbs up when you guys got your group, okay? All right, hey, where's my freshman guys at? Freshman guys, okay? Where's my sophomore guys? Okay, junior guys, where's my junior guys at? Okay, juniors and freshmen, you need to separate. And then senior guys, perfect. All right, where's my freshman ladies at? Raise your hand, freshman ladies. This is the group, freshman lady group. Here we are, good, okay. Where's our sophomores at? Sophomores, okay, juniors, and then seniors. Where's our seniors at? Seniors are right there, perfect. All right, so here's what we're gonna do, guys. You're gonna wanna listen up for this because this is the instruction part. This is how you know if you're gonna win. And there is a prize. I do have a prize, okay? So this game is called the Blob. I don't know why, don't ask me, that's just what it's called. What we're going to do is that on the screen, you will see a figure or you will see an item. And then what you would wanna do in your group is try to replicate that item as best as possible, only using your bodies, okay? So there's gonna be an item, let's say it was a rocket ship. You then would want to form a rocket ship using your entire group, okay? And here's where it gets interesting. Me and this guy, Jake, we are gonna be judging you based on who has the best one, and the person or the team that comes out with the most points will get the prize. Does this make sense? Give me the thumbs up. Are you guys good? Do you need any questions? Perfect. All right. Hey, Chase, throw the first one up there. What do we got? A car. You have 30 seconds. 30 seconds. This is where the creative people are thriving. You have 30 seconds and hold it when you get there because we're going to be judging.
That one. I don't know about that.
We're going to be judging.
Oh, that's not a car.
Ten seconds.
What's the game plan over here?
Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, and freeze. Freeze! I want to see this. Where are we at? I'm not really sure what's happening. It's kind of like a plane. This is a long boat. That's a smart car. Where are we at? I have no idea what this is.
I think there's a close competition between those two and here.
And here? I like the effort. This is kind of cool, but you know, I'm gonna have to go right over here. You guys get the first point. It was a good try. I'm sorry, maybe the next time. All right, round number two, let's see, what are we doing? A volcano, 30 seconds. You guys got to impress us. Make it elaborate.
I will see if you give me a Taco Bell with the bonus points. Oh, I think we might have a over here.
Make it elaborate. I want to see some creativity. I want to see some creativity. Ten seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and freeze. Freeze.
So I got one over here that looks really good, as that one over there too.
Okay, here's what I have to do. Just because they're the tallest ones, I'm gonna give the point right over here. They were the tallest. I'm sorry, they made a pyramid. It was fantastic. Hey, let's go round three. What do we got? Airplane, 30 seconds. If you guys can float somehow, I don't know, but that would be awesome.
I wanted to see behind the scenes, but now I'm letting go. Cause the safest place that I could be is in your brain, I know. I'm ready to chase if possible, walking away from what I know.
Ten seconds. Is this your whole team though? Is your whole team a part of it? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and freeze. Freeze.
Man, all right. I don't know. Honestly, it's between these two.
Jake, I'm going to let you choose, man. What do we got?
Hey, Joy, I do love you, but the girls get it.
Oh, the girls got it. Here we go. Next one. A church. 30 seconds. Ten seconds. Five, four, three, two, one, and freeze. This is a tough one. Listen, you guys look like you got the tallest, but it doesn't quite look like a church. I don't know. You guys are doing pretty good over here. Here's what I gotta say. Everybody did fantastic this round, but I'm gonna have to go right over here with the church. But the seniors, you also get a point because three men with the church. Come on, here we go. That's awesome. Hey, I think we have time for just one more really fast. Let's see the last one. Here we go, 30 seconds. 30 seconds. Five, four, three, two, and one. Freeze. Jake, I want you to choose this one, man. What do we got?
I just gotta say, y'all did a great job. But as a comic nerd, seniors get it.
The seniors get it. If you guys haven't seen the meme, it's hilarious. It is hilarious. Hey, so I think that means that, wait, junior girls, did you have 2 points? I think you guys won. Yeah. We got a prize for you. All right, here we go. Junior girls, here you go. Sharing the splendor. But hey guys, why don't you gather back around? We're actually gonna go back into a time of worship. But before we do, there's 2 announcements that I wanna make. So gather around, get back in this circle really fast. 2 announcements I wanna make. First one, what have we been talking about? What is next week? Rep your school night. Man, I'm so excited. I don't know about you, but anytime there's like a blow-up obstacle course, like I'm super into that. So make sure you invite somebody. Come next week. We're going to have a blast. Number 2, have you guys heard of this thing called Operation Christmas Child? Okay, we're actually going to be participating in this year. And so we'll give you some more information as time goes. Just know that we are doing this thing called Operation Christmas Child and start saving maybe some shoeboxes. Okay? Good deal. Hey, let's get back into worship.
Amen. Thank you guys so much for singing. We're going to invite you, if you guys would go to these chairs over here. We're going to sit in the first, like, I think 6 or 7 rows. Thank you so much. Head on over. Give a few high fives on your way over. Tell someone it's good to see them. Good to see all of you guys. High fives all around. There we go. Find a seat. Find a seat anywhere. Shane, that looks like a perfect seat for you right there. Yes. All right. Well, hey, again, thank you so much for... we like doing things different every once in a while at C7, so thank you for going with us. Did you guys enjoy acoustic worship tonight? Wasn't it awesome? Yes, awesome times. And so... Hey, I've asked Alexis, our middle school, she works with our middle school students, and she's amazing, and I've asked her to come in and share and speak with you guys tonight. And so, yeah, give it up for Alexis, she's awesome. Come on, give her a round of applause. And so, here's what we do. We're a note-taking group of people, so you take your notes out, put them in the air like you just do care. Let's see them. All right, she's going to say a lot of amazing, important things, and I'm going to ask you, as she does, that you would write them down so that when you go to your connect groups, you can remember it. And also, does anyone have their Bibles with their notes in them? Anyone have that? Can you put them in the air? Do you have it with you? It's okay. Yes. Yes, just like this. Hold it up high. We bring our paper Bibles sometimes. Yes, there we go. Oh, on your phone. That's awesome. There we go. And we make them this size intentionally so that you can slide them into your Bibles so that you can, like, here, can I borrow your Bible for a second? Yes, thank you so much. Perfect. See this? This is so, look at this. Everyone give this a round of applause. It's the Bible. Amen. Here we go, right? We want you to be able to remember your notes. So there's some of you that have notes from years and years ago, and that is our goal, that you remember what God taught you at C7. So give your undivided attention to Alexa. She's going to speak and encourage you tonight, okay? Let's go.
All right, guys. Well, I am so excited to be with you tonight. Usually, like Taylor said, I'm hanging out over in the multi-purpose room with our middle schoolers. So does anyone have any, like, middle school siblings? Or maybe anyone that just came out of 8th grade? Where am I freshman at? Nice. Very cool. So I'm really excited to be here tonight. Taylor asked me if I would share, and we're in a series right now on identity. Everyone say identity. How many of us know that identity is important? Right? What we put our identity in, what we get our identity from, that defines a lot of who we are and how we engage with the world. Our peers, our families, our students that we go to school with, it affects everything about who we are. So how many of us know that talking about identity and what God has to say about our identity, it's pretty important. So tonight, before we go into the word and before I just share a couple things, I think it's right for us to pray, don't you think? So God, we just come to you. God, we thank you for your word, that it's alive and it's active. And God, even though it was written thousands of years ago, it still applies to us today. It's not an old document that we have to brush off the dust with, but no, God, it's alive by your spirit. So God, would you use it to do what scripture does best, to correct and rebuke and to teach us and encourage us and all the things that scripture does. God, we just turn to you to speak about our identity. May it be found in you and not in this world. So God, we'll give you all of the praise for what you're gonna do through your word tonight. It's in your name that we pray, amen. So tonight we're going to be in John chapter 1. So if you have your real Bibles or your phone Bibles, would you scroll or flip there with me? We're going to be in John chapter 1, verses 43 through 49. So while you're flipping there, I'll just begin to read over us tonight. The next day, Jesus decided to leave for Galilee. Finding Philip, he said to him, "Follow me." Philip, like Andrew and Peter, was from the town of Bethsaida. Philip found Nathanael and told him, "We have found the one Moses wrote about in the law and about whom the prophets also wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." And then this is Nathanael's response. He says, "Nazareth? Psh, can anything good come from there?" "Come and see," said Philip. Then get this, when Jesus saw Nathanael approaching, he said to him, "Here truly is an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." "How do you know me?" Nathanael asked. Jesus answered, "I saw you while you were still under the fig tree before Philip called you." Then Nathanael declared, "Rabbi," which means teacher, "you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." It's a pretty cool passage of scripture. Tonight we're talking about how the right relationships can help us grow. The right relationships can help us grow. So I want to look at a few things in this passage that I think apply to what I just said. So first we notice that Philip told Nathanael about Jesus. He's like, hey, Philip. Philip said this, "Nathanael, we found the one. Moses and the prophets and all of these people in the Old Testament talked about this guy, Jesus, the Messiah who's gonna save us all. We found him." Now Nathanael's response, he's like, "You sure? Really? He's from Nazareth. Does anything good even come out of there?" That's like if someone were to say, "Sumner. Does anything good come out of Sumner?" We have a few good things, I think. We have a lot of really good coffee shops, so a couple good things. But people thought this about Nazareth along with Nathanael. But then I love Philip's response. He says, "Come and see." He invites him to be with Jesus. And what's cool is Jesus knew Nathanael before he even knew Jesus. And that's true of you and of I. Jesus knew you before you knew him. Pretty cool. And then we see Jesus, you know, he calls Nathanael. And he said, "Hey, just how I called Andrew and I called Peter and I called Philip, I'm calling you. You come and follow me." And Nathanael does. So what I want to propose to you tonight is, do you have a friend in your life or a relationship in your life that brings you closer to Jesus? Because we see in the example of Philip, he brought Nathanael to Jesus. He said, man, I hear you. I know you're a little skeptical, but come and see. Do you have a friend that's gonna do that? So really quickly, I wanna talk about two things really quick. One, have relationships that will help you grow towards Jesus. You need a friend like Philip, who's gonna say, you know what? You're gonna get off track every now and then. Maybe you're gonna be a little skeptical, but I'm gonna bring you back to Jesus. You need to have a friend that will listen to you and point you back to the truth. How many know there's times that we just need to rant? You're like, I just need someone that I can just let loose to. Here's all the things that's going on. I wanna challenge you this. Do you have a friend sometimes at the end of your rant session, let's say you're ranting about a friend or someone at school or whoever, that's like, you know, just starts ripping on this person. I can't believe this person did this. Did you see this? Did you see what they posted about me? Da 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 da. Do you have a friend who will listen, no questions asked, but say, yeah, but let's see what Jesus says about that? Or maybe tonight you find yourself, and maybe you only have friends that will listen to you, but will never push you closer to Jesus, that will always agree with you, but never challenge you to be better. Tonight, I want to challenge you. You need friends that will call you out and then will call you up. They'll call you out when you maybe wander off the path that Jesus has laid for you. And they'll call you up. They won't just leave you there. They'll be like Philip and say, no, come and see. Jesus actually has more for you. So maybe that's something that you need to think about tonight is your friendships. Do I have someone that calls me out in truth and in love? The second thing I want us to think about in this passage, be the friend that draws others to Jesus. Who are you bringing to Jesus? When's the last time that you talked about Jesus at your school? You know that kid in your math class that you sit next to all the time that lives a very different life than you? I know I've been there. I went to Sumner High School. Anyone other Sumner High School kids? Yeah, let's go Spartans. But when's the last time that you shared Jesus at school? When's the last time that you invited an unchurched friend to C7 with you? Maybe next week's your opportunity. But be someone that brings others to Jesus. Maybe you're here tonight and you're thinking, you know, I want this kind of friend, but I don't have any. Maybe tonight you're like, you know, this is all great, and I wish I had a friend that would call me out and call me up. I wish I had friends that could grow me in my faith, and I could grow in their faith, and we can have this awesome relationship and friendship that we just get to grow in Jesus together. But maybe you're like, I don't have that. You know, that's okay. But you need to find that. Because we actually can't follow Jesus alone. We need to have a community and others around us that are going to help us in our journey. I love this quote. There's a word in here that's gonna take you back to like freshman English for a moment. It says this, solo discipleship may as well be an oxymoron. I'm gonna read that one more time. Solo discipleship may as well be an oxymoron. We're not called to follow Jesus alone because following Jesus isn't easy. It comes with risk. It comes with being uncomfortable sometimes. And so we need people around us that are going to push us closer to Jesus and encourage us when we need encouragement, build us up, call us out in truth when we need it. But if you're here tonight and you're thinking, I don't have that, well, I wanna give you some practical steps of how to get it. Because one thing I know about Jesus is when I have prayed for friends, I've prayed for godly community, that is a prayer he's always said yes to. He's never said no. Now, was it always in my timing? Absolutely not. But he always said yes because he knows that we can't do it alone. So if you want to have some practical steps, I have three things for you tonight. The first, invite God into the process of finding the right relationships. Invite him in. When's the last time you prayed for friends? That you like genuinely went to God and you're like, Lord, I need friends. I need these people in scripture that you're talking about that I need to do life with. I need those. I've had that. I've had these moments where I'm just at the end of myself and I'm lonely and I'm like, Lord, I need some people. And he's so faithful, you guys. But you have to invite him into the process. And maybe if you have a great group of friends, do you have a mentor in your life? One, I'm gonna say yes, you do, because you have a bunch of incredible leaders that are in this. If you're a leader, would you just raise your hand really quick? All these people have gone through more life than you. Chances are they've been following Jesus a little bit longer. They've gone through the ups and the downs, the hills and the valleys of life, and they choose to be here every Sunday to speak into your life. They choose to come and to speak life and to encourage you. So you have a mentor, but do you engage in small group? Do you tap into the years of spiritual journeys that these saints have walked through? Ask them good questions. Engage in conversation. Pull them aside after a group and say, hey, you know, you said this. Could you speak into this a little bit more? There's this thing going on. Could you speak into it a little bit more? And do you have someone that you are mentoring? How often do you engage with a middle schooler out in the foyer? How often do you say, hey, I remember what it was like to be a sixth grader, and it's hard. But you know what? You'll get through it. You'll get through it. There's probably 100 kids, middle schoolers, sixth through eighth graders, that are sitting over there that would love to hear a word of encouragement from you. So maybe that's your challenge tonight. The last thing, I guess the second thing I'll say is put in the work. These relationships, they don't just come. Flowers don't bloom without being watered. So if you want relationships that are gonna help you grow in your faith, then you have to put in the work. You have to spend time with them and be intentional with the relationships that God has placed in front of you. And the last thing I'll say tonight is this, be faithful with your few. Society, culture, school tells you that you need to have 150 followers on Instagram. You need to have the most follows on TikTok, and your circle has to be bigger than you can even count. But what if Jesus' way is different? Did Jesus have 1,000 disciples? No. How many did he have? He had 12. And do you know what? Because of the faithfulness of those 12 and their relationship with each other and with Jesus are the reason that you and I are sitting here talking about Jesus today. Because they were faithful to continue the work that Jesus did by his Spirit and sharing it and spreading it to the ends of the earth is what the scriptures say. So be faithful with your few. Maybe God has placed only one or two or three or however around you, and you just need to be faithful with those few. You need to put in the work and invite God into those relationships. So I just said a lot of things in a very short amount of time. But as you go into small group, I just challenge you to engage tonight. Engage and lean in great conversations. You have amazing leaders. You have amazing students in your group. So just lean in. That's all we would ask for you tonight. So I'm going to pray for you, and then we'll dismiss the small group. God, we just come before you, and we just say thank you. Thank you that you don't call us to do life alone. We don't have to do life alone. In a world that's isolating and lonely, God, thank you that you call us to be in godly community, relationships that push one another more towards you. So God, may that be so tonight. Would we lean into our godly community that you've given us for the next half hour? May we lean in and learn from you. God, would you just bless our friendships and our relationships and those that are lonely tonight, God? We just pray right now that you would provide them friends, God. Provide them people that will push them and grow them in their faith. So, Lord, we love you and we thank you for all that you do in our lives. We'll give you all the glory and the honor. In your name, amen. Well, you guys can head to small groups and be blessed.